advocating violence, but I'm just reminding people, particularly white people who may want to characterize this as just angry black people, that this is actually the way that things have gotten done in this country.
Tonight, Portland is reeling. After 6 weeks of violence, protesters once again storming federal property, setting a fire at a courthouse. Oregon's attorney general is asking for a temporary restraining order to stop what she argues are unlawful arrests of protesters.
But they also are not giving any explanations for what they're doing or why they're doing it.
There's a racial component to this because he is linking Antifa to Democrats. Sometimes you can't fight people by, you know, praising them or being nice to them. You have to fight fire with fire sometimes. Listen, you know, no organization is perfect. There was some violence. No one condones the violence, but there were different reasons for Antifa.
President Trump suggested some demonstrators in Minnesota were out-of-state antagonists. Claims they did not back up with evidence.
I ran right past Vice. I ran right past BBC, who were busy filming useless, peaceful demonstrations while the real news was taking place ahead. And that's what citizen journalism has become. It's actually because the mainstream outlets are ignoring the truth. And I'm watching violence. I recorded it. And the sad thing is, it's out on the internet.
Crazy.
And still the left is saying it's a lie.
Autonomous Zone has turned into an almost street fair-like atmosphere with free food, art displays, and outdoor movie nights.
I want to be clear in how I characterize this. This is mostly a protest. It is not, generally speaking, unruly.
Now you've seen essentially almost like a street festival type atmosphere,
No,
with a very
it is not a street festival
with a very intentional purpose.
It is not a street festival. Do not say that.
Please.
Shame on you for saying that.
If you've been paying attention to the media for the last 4 years, it comes as no surprise to you that the media has been inciting and covering up for their violent left-wing foot soldiers. And by that, I mean groups like Antifa, By Any Means Necessary, and BLM. Things continue to escalate as we near closer to the election, and that should concern all of us, especially if you're not prepared. And if not, then please take a moment to hear about this special offer from my subscribers. When you see what's going on in our country right now, there's plenty to be concerned about. Social unrest is making life very uncomfortable, and it could quickly get worse. On top of that, a second wave of coronavirus is threatening to devastate our economy and our way of life again. Will we have severe food shortages this time? Will supply chains get cut off if people can't work? Will you even be able to go to the grocery store? These are realistic dangers, so don't let yourself be caught unprepared. Here's what to do right now. Go to www.preparewithdronetech.com and start building your emergency food supply today. The experts at My Patriot Supply are the only people I trust and use. And right now, you can save $100 off a full 4 week supply of delicious, nutritious meals the whole family will love. And saving $100 off a life-saving 4 week supply of food is too good to pass up. The second half of 2020 is gonna be wild. So go to preparewithdronetech.com and get ready right now. That's preparewithdronetech.com. Do it now. At this point, calling the media an ally of far-left extremist groups like Antifa and Black Lives Matter isn't an overstatement or hyperbole. They literally ignore all violence from these groups, or if they can't, they simply spin it as virtuous because they're the ones doing it. The problem is, Twitter is filled with videos of aggressive violence from so-called peaceful protesters, and not just in Portland, but from cities across this country. Yet the news media covers it all up and literally just pretends like it doesn't exist. Andy Ngo, an independent journalist, probably documents hundreds of examples of violence from these groups every week. And Andy knows all about Antifa violence because he himself, a gay Asian man, was targeted and attacked by members of the group. The media predictably blamed Andy himself and made excuses for Antifa. The same people that insist that Antifa is a good group because they call themselves anti-fascist. Of course, Nazis call themselves socialists, but that's completely different. So this is now the narrative that you're hearing across what we used to call the free press. And it's not just the cable news outlets, but the national network media that broadcasts across this country every single day.
Tonight, the mayors of several big cities, including New York and Chicago, are warning the president not to send federal officers to patrol their streets. The mayors are alarmed by the ongoing violence in Portland, Oregon, where protesters have battled for weeks with police and officers from the Department of Homeland Security.
Round after round of tear gas and rubber bullets fired into the crowd by federal agents is becoming a nightly routine.
Yeah, don't you know that opposing violent communist terrorists will always result in more violence and vandalism? You're supposed to just let them do whatever they want, terrorize whoever they want, and destroy whatever they want. Who cares if this has been going on for 50 straight nights? Of course, they'll never keep a running tally of how long this is going on or a list of their casualties, because the idea here is to cover up the violent communist uprising and frame it as peaceful, nonpartisan protesters.
This unnamed protester says he collected some of the spent ammunition.
What was it like when they all came out there?
War, literal war. Except you can't fire back on your enemy.
Oh yeah, what's more mainstream America than wishing you could shoot your enemy, also known as the police? Just take a minute to fully absorb what you just watched. A far-left extremist who claims they're at war and wants to shoot back at their enemy.
What was it like when they all came out there?
War, literal war. Except you can't fire back on your enemy.
The enemy being anyone who opposes their actions. And we know that's the case because what did the network news just tell us? That opposing these groups is what leads to escalated violence and vandalism. And just look at this guy. Nothing about him looks peaceful. He looks like he came for a fight. But instead of scrutinizing these people, ABC, NBC, and CBS lie by omission.
Mayors from six cities have written the Trump administration demanding the president take immediate action to withdraw your forces. Among those tear gassed, ER Dr. Sharon Myron, who's also a county commissioner.
What the Trump administration calls anarchy, sort of what we call democracy. So.
Wow! So she's under the mistaken impression that using terroristic violence to get your demands met is the very definition of democracy. That's not democracy, it's literally the definition of terrorism. This lady was with the so-called Portland Moms, who actually turned out to be the violent protesters, but just putting on yellow t-shirts and calling themselves moms. Some of them actually encouraging violence by handing off concrete blocks to be thrown at police. Just imagine for a moment that these protests all over the country were actually centered to right-leaning conservatives and libertarians. And we already know this because of how they attacked and demonized the peaceful Tea Party protests, and more recently, how they demonized the peaceful anti-lockdown protests, some of them being labeled terrorists. Meanwhile, actual terrorists get fake fact-checkers to warp reality to their political needs. Over at Snopes, they took issue with, quote, right-leaning media reports that a fundraiser for the Black Lives Matter group is a convicted left-wing terrorist who was pardoned quietly by Bill Clinton on his way out. They focused on this Twitter post, saying, quote, Susan Rosenberg is a convicted terrorist who sat on the board of directors of Thousand Currents, an organization which handles fundraising for the Black Lives Matter global network. Despite this claim being 100% accurate, Snopes, a self-labeled fact-checker, gave this indisputable fact a, quote, mixture rating. Just listen to this convoluted horse shit. What's true? Susan Rosenberg has served as vice chair on the board of directors for Thousand Currents, an organization that provides fundraising and fiscal sponsorship for the Black Lives Matter global movement. She was an active member of revolutionary left-wing movements whose illegal activities included bombing U.S. government buildings and committing armed robberies. Okay, you just confirmed the claim. Oh no, what's this? What's undetermined? In the absence of a single universally agreed upon definition of terrorism, it is a matter of subjective determination as to whether the actions for which Rosenberg was convicted and imprisoned, possession of weapons and hundreds of pounds of explosives, should be described as acts of domestic terrorism. Oh, she's not really a terrorist because when left-wingers do it, it's different. Oh, and by the way, there is an accepted definition of terrorism, which is the unlawful use of violence and intimidation, especially against civilians, in the pursuit of political aims. Well, that sounds exactly like what Susan Rosenberg was convicted of. It also sounds exactly like what Antifa and BLM are doing on a regular basis. And I'm sorry to say that it's gone even further than that recently, with partisan extremist prosecutors letting violent terrorists off the hook for rioting, looting, and attacking people, while pursuing charges against lawful citizens who defend themselves against those very same violent mobs. Are you noticing a trend here? The left gets violent, and any response to that violence is framed as wrong. They really want to take away your ability to defend yourself on all fronts. There's little doubt to me at this point that we're entering a very dangerous era in this country, and it's being ushered in by the Democrats and their media. You can help me continue this fight by supporting this channel's sponsors. In this case, preparewithdronetech.com. You can also support me by donating on one of these platforms. You can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. Thanks for all your support. Keep coming back.